It's a little after 8:30, and as the name suggests, it's time for South Africa's number one news show, not the 8:45 news. The show that is dedicated today to the memory of the plastic carrier bag who was tragically killed yesterday by politicians who have lost focus on real priorities in the country.
Featuring reports from our international team of journalists, including those based in Randburg, Randfontein, Randgate, Randhart, Rankieslachter, Rand Park, Rand View, Rand Val, Rand Riss, Rand Ridge Park, and Nunoti.
And presented as usual by the men that women love to hate, the man with no rands, Vikash Mathura.
And Ray Maraj, good morning.
Good morning, but first as usual, a word from our chief sponsors for the morning news.
Muluk.
And it's on Todd Top Story. According to the latest medical reports, the SARS virus is worse than previously thought. Doctors now say that the SARS virus can live on a toilet seat for up to 4 days. This comes as a shock to millions of people in the Far East and other parts of the world who have now realized that they've been wearing their masks on the wrong end.
Still with international news, Oprah Winfrey is expected to renew her contract for a television show for over $140 million per year. On hearing the news, local talk show host Felicia immediately booked herself in for more plastic surgery. And we'll be back after a visit to the marketplace.
Dhania karela methi bhaji. Bring your aja and your aji. Tomatoes, potatoes and half-ripe berries available only at quarter price from Harry's. And this week's specials, everybody, if you come to my stall at Clearwood Market, we got round two of the Salusa 55 pop stars. That's right. All semi-finalists must please wear miniskirts and boob tubes. That's for the ladies, of course, because Ashok Ramchandra was getting excited when I said that he must wear boob tubes. He thought he could also dress up in that type of clothes. And of course, all men finalists must wear loose-fitting, oversized jeans tied with an old tie, one-torn vest, and baseball cap worn sideways. If you don't know what I'm talking about, visit the Lotus FM website and look at a picture of Suresh Harilal. Our celebrity judge this week is somebody with enough time on his hands. His name is Vali Musa. He'll also demonstrate how it's possible to go to a market like my stall at Clearwood and buy 1/2 kg green beans, 1/2 kg green chilies, 1 kg monkey nuts, 2 kg jam tomatoes, 2 kg soft cooking potatoes, that's gravy soakers, 1 bunch dhania, 1 bunch pudina, 6 bunch methi bhaji, 1/2 kg shlobu, 200 gram garam masala and 100 gram curry powder, and to put it into one environmentally friendly carrier basket without using their plastic packets. And just a reminder that our big bonanza prize in the Salusa 55 pop stars competition is third prize trip for two to Mauritius, second prize we got home theater system, and first prize is 130 micron environmentally friendly biodegradable natural colored and politically correct plastic packet courtesy of the Department of Environmental Affairs. So don't forget, everybody, dhania karela methi bhaji, bring your aja and your aji.
We're back.
News just in now. The KZN town of Verulam will soon have its own museum and documentation center depicting the history of the town. For those who have never heard of the place, Verulam is a small town approximately 30 kilometers north of Durban. The town was so small that once they held a boxing match there and both boxers had to sit in the same corner. Once they also held a beauty contest and believe it or not, Chital Maharaj won.
Verulam was so dull that the post office used to sell picture postcards of other towns, and if you went out for a night on the town in Verulam, it only took 7 minutes. Verulam didn't have a sanitation department in those days. They had a cleaning lady who came in once a week. It was so small, the town of Verulam, that the 7-Eleven used to close at 6 o'clock. And we'll be back after this commercial break.
Hello, everybody. The KZN Tourism Board, in conjunction with the Dolphin Coast Tourism Board, invites you to visit Tongaat Beach.
Tongaat Beach has everything. Sand for the children.
Sun for the wife.
And sharks for the wife's mother.
Tongaat Beach. The jewel of the Dolphin Coast.
Only 20 minutes from Verulam, just 30 minutes from Durban, 5 minutes away from the ecological disaster, the Umhlanga River mouth, and 15 minutes away from the Naval Twister, that's your free roller coaster ride on the beach road near Umhlanga.
We're back. Renuka Maharaj, wife of Lotus FM celebrity drag queen Ray Maharaj, has failed her driver's test for the 27th time. Ray is reported to be furious. He's now convinced that she's having an affair with the tester.
And to get even, and finally, proof that Vikash Mathura was the ugliest child ever. Apparently, when Vikash was just 3 years old, his mother took him to a pet store to browse. And as they walked out of the store, the alarm went off.
Wow, 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 wow.
That's the end of the news for this week.
Until next Saturday.
Or the 17th of May.
Whichever comes first.
Happy Mother's Day.
Woof. All the ladies to wear boob tubes? What about the old ladies? How are they gonna wear?
Okay, and Professor Pyarelal on Lotus FM's Weekend Touchdown today is brought to you with the compliments of the Monte Vista Casino.
Hello, Muna. Hello, my baby. Sipo, 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 darling.
Sipo, bo, kuta ko bahala ya. Ho, 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 ho.
Ah, you're such a cute baby.
I must beg your pardon, Mr. A. It's a little early for the baby this morning. But wait, how are you?
I'm well, but let me just speak to the baby.
Aha, aha.
Baby, Muna. Say, Ray Kaka.
Ray.
Yeah, you sir. Yes, my darling. Ray Kaka. Say, Ray Kaka.
Ray Kaka.
No, my darling. No, no. It's Ray Kaka, Munna.
Ray Kaka, Munna. Ray Kaka, Munna.
Let me speak to your father.
Daddy. Ha, bol, Mr. Ray. How are you this fine morning?
You know, as a professor of linguistics, I would expect you to focus on your son's pronunciation.
Well, I try with a limited range of success, Mr. Ray. You must understand, Sipo Junior is only 5 months old, Mr. Ray.
I appreciate that, but it's not very flattering when he uses the wrong pronunciation when he talks to me every single week on national radio.
But Mr. Ray,
I'm not sure if I'm overreacting. He's a five-month-old baby. But I have a reputation as well.
Well, Mr. A, you must understand, Sipo Jr. has been passed as a baby with a genius intellect.
Yeah, but with faulty pronunciation.
Not particularly. Perhaps the baby is trying to tell you something, Mr. A. Like that you are full of, you know. So, Mr. A, as they say in the movies...
Yeah, namaskar to you, Professor.
Go figure.
Go figure. Tell me, Professor.
Ha, bol, Mr. A.
Please confirm for me.
Well, I'm not particularly certain if I want to even try and confirm.
Sipo indicated that Biju is AWOL.
Sipo who?
You know which Sipo I'm talking about.
Sipo who, Mr. A? There is no significant Sipo in my life or in my baby's life. Or even in my wife's life.
That is what you are saying, but could you confirm for me that Biju is at home and not out of the country?
Fine. I will confirm it in a way that will convince everybody who is listening in.
Yeah.
Mr. A.
Yes.
My wife is at home.
And what proof do we have?
Well, my word is my proof.
I can't accept that. I need further proof.
Ha. Huh. 1 minute. I will call home right now. And I will talk to Biju.
On your mobile?
Will that satisfy your doubt, Mr. A?
All right. The phone, let's hear the conversation.
Morning, darling. Happy Mother's Day. Can you tell everybody that you are at home, safe and sound? I love you too. I love you. I love you. I love you more. No, I love you. I love you. Love, love, right now. Now. Love you. Love, 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 love. Love, love, you. Love you. Love you. Ah, fine, you love me more. I will come later home and we will debate further. Love you. Thank you. Mr. A,
yes.
Are you now convinced?
I only heard one side of the conversation, Professor.
Well, probably there was faulty lines, Mr. A.
Yes, probably there was.
Well, look, not to tell that we don't have our fair share of arguments.
Yes, of course.
Just for yesterday, for example, I was talking with Biju. And Biju was saying, she was saying, Prof, all Indian men are stupid.
She calls you Prof.
As an affectionate way, Mr. A.
Yeah.
She said, Prof, all affectionate, all Indian men are stupid.
All Indian men are stupid.
Ah, that is what she said.
That's a terrible thing to say.
Well, we were having a sexist argument, you see. And I said, but Biju, you must understand, it was the Indian man, for example, who invented the toilet seat.
Yeah, that's so true, Professor. Well done. Well said. Well said.
And she said to me, Prof, you must remember, it was an Indian woman who remembered to put a hole in the middle of it. Now, what do you say to something like that?
To see her.
But you know, I've been trying to improve my my command of English language. And I was invited to seminar, you know, for masters and doctorates and professorship students.
Yeah.
And there I went into the class. And it is a class for highly academically qualified people. But people who are not speaking English as first language, you must understand.
Yeah.
And so I walked into the class. And I can recall, this is last week.
This was an ESL class.
What is ESL?
English was as second language.
That is what is said. That is what is said. And I walked into the class pretty late, you know.
Or EFL.
EFL?
English is a foreign language.
That too, Mr. A.
Right.
That's what is said. And I walked into my class late and I took a seat at the back of the class. And the professor who was lecturing, he said to me, he said, Professor Pyarelal, why are you late? I said, because of the sign.
What sign?
He said, what sign? I said, the sign that says outside, school ahead, go slow. Then he says, fine, are you a scientific person? I said, yes, sir, I am. He said, what is the chemical formula for water? I said, for water. He said, right, what is chemical formula for water? I said, chemical formula is easy. It's H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O.
Why?
He said, what are you talking about?
Yes, what are you talking about?
I said, because everybody says it's from H2O, right?
You're the genius, Professor. You're the genius.
Now, you was talking about Columbus discovering America a little earlier.
Yes.
I was sitting in this classroom and there was another doctor who was requested to go to the board and to point at the map. And to show everybody in the class where America is. And he did so. And then the teacher said, now who discovered America? And I said, that fella did. I pointed him. What a stupid question, you know.
Absolutely. What a stupid question. Professor, the word for today is...
How bold, Mr. A?
Virago. That's V-I-R-A-G-O, Virago.
It's like a Latin American word.
Yes.
And started in this valley...
In India?
No, right here in Chatsworth. You see, virago is like a kind of noun.
Yeah.
Right?
That's brilliant.
That's what it said.
That's correct.
It's a kind of noun which means it's a name given to something.
Yes.
Now, for example, Mr. A, if you want to tell somebody to leave.
To leave.
To leave.
Leave.
To leave.
What's leave?
Leave.
To leave. Yes.
If you want to tell somebody to leave, you'll tell them to go, right?
Yeah.
Now, specific to radio industry, people have been requesting that Vikash and Ray also must go.
Lots of listeners, in fact, all five of them that write to the press on a regular basis. Yeah.
They want the two uncles, Peru and Bala, for example, to stay and do the show, and for Mr. Vikash and Mr. Ray to leave.
Right.
So that process where lots of people get together and form a little syndicate.
Yeah.
And they ask you to leave. It's called virago because V is for Vikash, Ra is for Ray, and Go is to leave. So virago is like asking Mr. Ray and Mr. Vikash to leave.
That's brilliant, Professor.
That's what it's say.
That's absolutely brilliant. So it's not so much Chatsworth, it's Devon Central.
No, it started in Chatsworth, Mr. A, because
was it the first letter writer
was
from there?
There.
And the first letter writer was obviously from that area as well.
That's what it said, and lots of people don't know. They think Mr. Vikash was born in Paris, but he was born in Unit 1 in Chatsworth.
That's right. But we have an alternative meaning for the word virago. And it is a noun, as you indicated. And a virago is a loud, overbearing, quarrelsome woman.
Right.
Virago.
Right. Now, Mr. Ray.
Yes, Professor.
If we as internal people of the South African Broadcasting Association know exactly where some of these letters are coming from, do I need to say anything further, Mr. Ray?
Say no more, Professor.
Who is the genius, Mr. Ray?
Professor, you are the genius.
I thank you, Mr. Ray.
And just before you go...
Just before I go, I want to say something very special to all the special people listening today.
The mothers?
Not particularly. I want to ask a question to one particular individual. Mr. Sipo.
Yeah.
Who made some really unrealistic comments yesterday that he's now gone underground.
Yeah.
The only kind of mammal that can survive underground is a mole.
That's right.
Which is blind, which has no idea in which direction it is moving. And you stay there, Mr. Sipo. You stay underground.
But just a question that I have for you, Professor, because I still have no confirmation that your wife Biju is at home.
Well, what confirmation do you need, Mr. Ray? Am I worried about your wife?
And she could very well be overseas where you contacted her over the telephone if that was indeed her on the phone when you did call.
Is it my business of where your wife is, Mr. Ray? Well, actually it is, just between you.
Just before you go.
I noticed you cut that very short, Mr. Ray.
Time's of the essence. Is the baby awake?
To my lovely wife, Biju, I want to wish a happy Mother's Day.
What about your mummy back home in UP?
She can't hear, Mr. Ray. It's pretty far, but I will call her later. I want to wish one other special person in my life, to Renuka, happy Mother's Day for today. Just keep up with the story. Don't let anything out. And to Charisma, my beautiful child, Daddy loves you. I'm old, Mr. Ray, you were saying? You were short breath, Mr. Ray. You got short breath today?
Could I speak to Sipo Jr.?
Eight minute, Mr. Ray. Sipo? Hello, ball, Sipo. Ball.
Darling. Say, Ray Kaka, darling.
Mr. Ray, Sipo Jr. loves the Ninja Turtles.
Oh, he does, he?
Huh.
Okay.
Sipo Ball.
Ninja.
That's beautiful.
Ninja.
Hey. Namaskar, Mr. Ray.
Namaskar. Namaskar, Professor.
Namaskar, Mr. Ray.
And how are you doing this morning, Professor?
I was sitting here wondering. I was just wondering to myself.
Yes.
If there was going to be a time where you would actually talk to me rather than talk about things like plastic surgery.
No, it's not plastic surgery, it's plastic bags.
But that's what is said. Michael Jackson looks like a plastic bag.
It does, Professor.
That's what is said.
My apologies for...
I am also over the moon.
About?
Over the planets, as you would call it. That people have SMS'd you to tell you to stop talking about the politics of the country but that they would rather listen to me, that is most overwhelming.
Yes, probably your family members.
That's what he said.
Professor, did you go to the IFA Awards last night?
Well, Mr. Ray, did you not watch the awards?
Yes, I did part
of it. I was there.
You were there?
I was there. Mm-hmm. I was the one who hosted the show.
I thought Anil Kapoor hosted the show.
Mr. Ray, you know that I'm a man of many disguises. I was supposed to have played the role of the saint. Unfortunately, Val Kilmer charged them little less. And that's why he was chosen for the role.
You and Anil Kapoor...
I was looking like Anil Kapoor because he couldn't make it. And at last minute, they came to me and they said, Professor, please, we are in dire straits. I said, I don't listen to pop music. I said, what can I do? They said, no, we need a compere. I said, fine. I will look like Anil Kapoor, and of course my makeup artist was there. It was me, Mr. A.
I thought there was something strange because Anil Kapoor doesn't do comedy.
Well, exactly. That's what he said. It was me impersonating Mr. Anil Kapoor.
So you're a very good-looking guy.
Well, I've had my moments, Mr. A.
Yes, I'm sure.
I do have my moments. Matter of fact, I spent most of yesterday afternoon trying to teach English to some of the Indian celebrities from India.
For the speeches?
Industry. That's what he said.
Mm-hmm.
Because they would have to do what you would call acceptance speeches.
Yeah, of course.
And it is not proper if they don't know how to speak a decent command of the English language.
So who did you tutor?
Well, I tried to tutor Amitabh Bachchan.
Yeah, he did a fine job, didn't
he? He's a quick learner, Mr. Ray, because he learnt how to speak the English language in his proper vocab in a matter of 20 minutes.
And I thought his message about piracy was very important as well.
Well, I was thinking about you and Mr. Vikash at the time, because of course piracy affects everybody who is trying to make some inroads in the music industry of the country.
And all other local artists as well, of course.
That's what he said.
Mm-hmm.
But I had a few problems.
What happened, Professor?
Trying to teach English, I had a few problems in trying to communicate properly with certain individuals.
Such as?
One of them was the legendary music producer, Anandji.
Anandji was there last night, apparently, yes.
That's correct. He got a Lifetime Achievement Award for contribution to Indian cinema. Just before the award ceremony, I was requested by some very prominent politicians to teach him few words of English, just to assist with his acceptance speech. I said to him, after teaching him the basics, I said, tell me, Anandji, tell me frankly, do you say prayers before you eat? And he said, no. I said, why? He said, because my wife is a good cook. He's developed a sense of humor.
He has, hasn't he?
So I asked Anandji, and of course Shakti Kapoor was there as well in my English class in the afternoon. Just before commencement of IFA Awards, I had Shakti Kapoor and Anandji in the class with me. And I said, gentlemen, I've taught you so much about English in past hour. Now please write one composition, simple one, and use the English words I taught you. And I said, write a composition about your dog.
The dog?
That's what he said. And so I left them for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I must tell you, Shakti Kapoor is not only a villain in the movies, he's a bit of a villain when it comes to learning. Because he copied his composition from Anandji.
His composition and Anandji's composition were exactly the same.
That's what he said.
Yeah, but that's cheating.
That's plagiarism, Mr. A.
Yes, you say it is.
I said to Shakti, after I saw the composition, I said, Shakti Kapoor, you've got the same composition as Anandji. Did you copy? Why is it exactly the same?
Yeah.
And he said to me, ow, that's because we've got the same dog. We're on the same dog.
Tell me, did they allow you to take in a little Sipo Jr. to the IFA Awards last night?
Mr. Aid was a prerequisite.
I thought there was an age restriction, no kids under the age of 9.
No, but because of his ingenious intellect at a young age, Mr. He's only 5 months now.
Yes, 5 months old, that's right.
He was actually...
But he's a precocious kid, isn't he?
He's a bit of that as well.
Yes.
What did you call him?
Precocious.
course. Yes, he's a bit of that mystery.
Yes.
But what he was doing last night, he was operating the teleprompter.
Oh, for you?
For everybody.
Uh-huh.
Of course, Mr. Bachchan's speech was on teleprompter.
It must have been, yes.
Right. And Sipo Junior was operating. And that is why they allowed him. He's quite an ingenious kid, Mr. A.
Uh-huh.
As you're well aware.
Is he in the studio this morning?
I do believe, Mr. A, that he is here.
Munna. Hello, my baby. Munna. Sipo.
Hello, Mr. A.
No. Bachchan.
Aha. Sipo?
Put the baby on here.
Kaka go namaste ball.
Say it's Ray Kaka.
Ritik Roshan.
No, not Ritik. Ray Kaka.
Ray Kaka.
Hello, my darling.
Hello, Mr. A.
No. Professor, I'm talking to the baby.
I do beg your pardon, Mr. A.
Ray Kaka here, my... Hello, my baby. Darling. Hello, my baby. Hello, my cook-nana. Naughty boy. Sipo, naughty boy.
Naughty.
Kaka, darling.
Kaka.
Ray Kaka.
Mama.
No, Ray Kaka, darling.
Pupo.
No, Ray Kaka, darling. Baby, don't cry.
Obviously, he's a bit upset at the time being.
Why?
Well, I think he's messed nappy a little bit. Either that or Mr. Vikash left the studio in a hurry for a particular reason.
So tell us about the IFA Awards, Professor.
A wonderful event. It was nice to see so many people, but one of my old colleagues was there, and I was most taken aback by his wonderful words of wisdom.
And who was this?
Mr. Dev Anand.
Yes, he was brilliant, wasn't he?
Well, the man is 80 years old, Mr. A, and he's...
Just one question. Did he have hair dye? Was that his natural hair, or is that a wig?
I must tell you, Mr. A, that is Mr. Dev Anand's natural hair.
Are you serious?
Albeit that it is dyed a bit of the color, if you know what I mean.
It has been dyed, okay.
It's been dyed, but it's natural hair.
Uh-huh.
But the man speaks with such power.
Such passion, absolutely.
With such passion. And we were all taken aback. We cried and cried and cried and cried.
Uh-huh.
Because at one stage, he refused to go off the stage.
I know.
So we cried.
I had the same feeling as well.
Matter of fact, there was a time when Saif Ali Khan came onto the stage.
And was trying to lead him off.
They started to clap.
Yes.
But the more they clapped, the more inspiration he got to just keep talking.
Did you spend a few private moments with Rekha backstage?
Mr. A, there is a reason why they call it private moments.
Uh-huh. She's a very beautiful woman, isn't she?
My goodness, Mr. A, she's what they would call a knockout.
Knockout.
A knockout.
And how old is she?
Rekha G is probably in the late 40s. I would assume she's probably 50 at the most. Maybe even going on 51, 52.
But she's probably looking early 20s.
Say she could be 53.
Right.
My guess is she's probably around about 52.
But she's gorgeous. She's a stunner, isn't she?
She's such a beauty. She's a sexy siren of Bollywood. But a respectable woman for many a year.
Uh-huh.
Then, of course, one of my all-time favorites was also there.
This was?
You're not thinking, Mr. A.
One of your old favorites.
My all-time favorite celebrities was there as well.
Tuntun?
Not Nash. He was not there. There wasn't sufficient space.
Right. I can't remember.
Mr. Salman Khan.
Yes, Mr. Salman Khan was there.
What a man.
Yes.
It was pity that in that rope that he tied himself to when he jumped from the roof and landed in the middle of the audience.
Uh-huh.
It took him 3 minutes to try and untie the rope. It was quite an interesting experience, Mr. A.
No, I'm sure that was just part of the comedy gig.
I suggest you try the same technique with your wife.
Tying her up in rope?
And asking her to jump from the ceiling.
Professor, the word for today is popinjay.
Popinjay.
That's right.
That's such a beautiful word.
It's P-O-P-I-N-J-A-Y, popinjay.
The word is a kind of noun. Although sometimes it could be misinterpreted as a noun, but actually it is not a noun.
It is a noun.
But that's why I say sometimes.
Yes,
this
yes.
is not one of those sometimes moments.
Yes.
The word is noun.
Yes, it is a noun.
It's a name given to something.
Yeah, that's brilliant.
That's what I said.
Mm-hmm.
Now you see, usually when you invite people
yeah.
to come into your house
uh-huh.
for a cup of tea,
yeah.
for some masala chai,
mm-hmm.
or just for a shot of Johnny Walker Black.
Or blue.
That's what I said. Now that's the kind of movies you'll watch.
No. Johnny Walker Blue.
That's what I said. Then what you would do when you extend an invitation,
to
you would
people.
Ask somebody to pop in.
Right.
You know, are you doing anything, Mr. Tubby? If you're not, why don't you pop in?
Uh-huh.
And of course, you and I know that Tubby waits for that kind of invitation.
Yes, he does.
However, this particular phrase, pop in jail, refers specifically to the time back 11 years ago.
What happened 11 years ago?
When Mr. Vikash said to a very famous radio celebrity at the time.
JJ.
He gave an invitation
yeah.
to pop into his house for 21st birthday party. So he said, Jay, if you're doing nothing,
uh-huh.
pop in, Jay. And we know what happens subsequently.
Then the rest is history.
So pop in, Jay is a kind of invitation you would extend
uh-huh.
that eventually leads to a kind of life sentence. If you know what I mean, Mr.
Okay, but there's an alternative meaning for the word, Professor.
Humble, Mr.
A popinjay is a noun, as you indicated. It is a strutting, supercilious person, someone who feels that they're superior or haughtily contemptuous. For example, the staff at Lotus FM soon learned to ignore the vain arrogance of the temperamental popinjay who was the breakfast DJ.
Mr. A.
Professor.
Are you acquainted with a certain Mrs. J?
Yes, I am.
Is she not a strutting, vain kind of person?
You said it, Professor.
That's not a saying. That's not a saying.
Namaskar.
Dolia?
Hey, Dolia. Dolia. Dolia?
What happened?
What happened, Marcia? Dolia?
I'm busy doing aerobics, folks.
Hey,
what do you want?
What you are doing, darling?
I can never do anything in this house without getting disturbed, man. Why are you laughing? I'm doing aerobics.
You're doing aerobics, darling?
Ha, dekna.
Hey, batao.
Ha, one.
Huh?
Stretch. Two.
Huh?
Get up.
Darling.
Ha, bol.
I come and see this funny comic strip in the paper, Dolia.
Pooks, that's not funny. You want to know what's a funny comic strip, Pooks?
Nay, ball, darling.
You, in the bathroom.
Oh.
Now, why you call me?
What's funny about me in the bathroom?
Nay, I'm just saying.
There's a comic strip for you.
Pooks, by the way, you saw Ruby's 2000 and Sari.
2,000 rand sari, Dolia?
Uh-huh, so small you wrote here.
Was it a birthday?
No.
Must have been an anniversary then.
Nay.
And then what she got 2,000 rand sari for? Her husband not that rich.
He bought her a sari for a hug.
Hug, Dolia?
Uh-huh.
And?
And kiss.
For one hug and a kiss?
Huh?
You mean... Just because Ruby gave him a hug and a kiss,
huh?
He had to buy her such an expensive sari.
No.
Huh?
Ha, kuch hai
yahan. Boy.
Ruby saw him giving the maid a hug and a kiss. That's why he had to buy her a sari.
Hey, lucky I'm not like that, Dolia. You can never expect big expensive sari like that. Because I would never hug my maid. Yeah.
You never hug.
Yeah.
You just kiss and run quickly. Yeah, I'm so proud of you to have a husband like you, Pooks.
Yeah.
I'll never get expensive saris from you.
Now, for your anniversary, I'll buy, darling.
Yeah, I'm trying to encourage you, Pooks, to go hug and kiss the maid.
Huh?
At least I'll have something to ask for after that to keep quiet, you know?
Fair coat, darling.
Fair coat. Get kiss quickly.
You want to wear fair coat? You saw your size already.
You always pick on my size.
jumbo aise hai.
Your mother was right.
Iko ka bolat.
Your mother was right.
Ka bolat.
I should have married your brother.
Okay. I'm a super weird.
Okay, darling. I was almost afraid Vikash would say.
Let's get away from here before we get into more trouble. 10 to 1 o'clock, your special songs on Lotus FM with Rakesh Ramdin. It's now 2 minutes after 10. Have a splendiferous week, everybody. We'll talk to you next Saturday morning for the weekend touchdown with Ray Maharaj in Durban.
And Vikash Mathura in Johannesburg.
And until we communicate on the airwaves of Lotus FM again, don't forget, whatever you do,
don't drive any faster
than your guardian angel can fly. FM's Weekend Liftoff, Lara Dutta, Akshay Kumar and Priyanka Chopra co-star in the movie Andaz. It's got a fantastic soundtrack, including the piece of music you just heard with Udit Narayan, I beg your pardon, Sonu Nigam and Alka Yagnik. 11 after 9 Saturday morning, Uncle Spiru and Bala are on the way.
Yeah, just before that, I omitted to give the names of those that got the cryptic clue correct the last hour. Correct answers from Mr. M.R. Radio from Zinto, Praveen Sham of Quadaguza, Dr. Vishram, the old Reservoir Hills, Farouk Ismail of Quadaguza, Rajan Govinda of Durban, and Mr. S.V. Radio from Zinto. Well done to you guys.
Children, say Mayuri.
Mayuri!
Where's the best Mother's Day sale?
Mayuri!
Which jewelry store has less 40% on all Mangalsutra chains and hand chains?
Mayuri!
Very good. Okay, here comes Dad. All together now.
Mayuri!
Well, I guess I know where I'm getting Mum's Mother's Day gift from.
Mayuri!
There's magic at Mayuri's this Mother's Day. Visit Mayuri's at the Chatswood Center, Phoenix Plaza, or Northway Mall, Peter Maritzburg.
Hello, darling. I brought you an aspirin and water for your headache.
But baby, I don't have a headache.
Oh, jolly good. That's just what I wanted to hear. How about some...
No, baby, not on this bed. It's already broken.
Okay, darling. I will buy you a new bed from the Mattress King on Edwin Swales Drive at the Bluff, or even closer at Springfield Park. It's their 12th birthday.
Oh, sweetie, come here. Mwah, mwah, mwah.
The Mattress King, for the right bed at the right price. Sunny Gayadin has done it again. Back by popular demand, the legendary Kumar Sanu.
Hello, South Africa. I'm Kumar Sanu. I will be performing in Durban and Sandton.
Durban, Westridge, Friday 23rd May at 8 p.m. Tickets from 60 Rand, reserved from 80 Rand. The fabulous Sandton Convention Center, Sunday 25th May, 3 p.m. Tickets reserved from 100 Rand. Secure...
The water's hotter.
Technically. Okay, I want a better response than that.
Okay, it's probably the metal that gets heated and then goes down quicker.
Okay, Anita, I'm going to put you on hold because I haven't quite got the correct answer there. Any of the other ladies? Any of the other ladies want to venture an answer? Which coin will fall to the bottom faster? The water at 31 degrees Fahrenheit or the one...
Varsha,
yes, give us your response.
31?
Yeah.
The hotter the water, it will fall.
So, will it fall faster on the 31 or the 41 degrees Fahrenheit?
41, I think.
41, that's not the answer I was looking for. Next caller. Okay, we're speaking to?
So the question again is, you've got two glasses of water. One glass, the temperature in one glass is 31 degrees. The temperature of the water in the other glass is 41 degrees Fahrenheit.
Fahrenheit, that's right.
Yes.
You drop a coin into both the glasses. One coin will fall to the bottom faster. Why?
Which glass and why?
Is it 41 degrees?
Tell us why.
Because it's less dense.
Yeah, okay, we're getting some strange answers. And the final Kapila, I think that, it is.
That's what Sanchez's family says to him all the time.
He's less dense?
He's less dense.
Yes. Okay, and Kapila?
Yes?
Hi, what's your response?
I said it's 41 degrees because it's less dense.
I haven't got a correct response from any one of you. The answer that I was looking for is not correct.
Yeah. And we must point out at this stage that I cracked this one.
You did.
So it should be easy for the ladies to crack it.
Okay, now what I want you to do is, all four of you, I want you to run around, shout around, find out what the equivalent of 31 degrees Fahrenheit is in Celsius terms.
Ray?
Yes.
Can't you ask her something about the Indian bouquet would be?
No, no. I've got a final question. Find out what the equivalent of 31 degrees Fahrenheit is in Celsius, and you will be able to crack it then. Do your research. We'll give you a few seconds to do your research.
Yes. Anita.
Yes, what's your answer?
One of them is frozen.
That's right. Which one is frozen? The 31 degrees Fahrenheit is 0 degrees Celsius.
Yes.
Okay. Who are you talking to again?
Anita.
Anita, right. Here's your final question. Who is the showmaster? This is your final question, right?
Mm-hmm.
Who is the presenter of the DSTV Funky Family Showdown? I'll give you a choice of three.
Yes. Mervyn Pillay.
Is it Mervyn Pillay? Is it Eugen Naidu? Is it Vimla Frank?
It's Eugen Naidu.
Congratulations. You've won the DSTV satellite system.
Thank
worth
you.
In excess of 2,500 Rand with full installation.
Thank you so much, Ray, and because...
Anita, are you married?
Yes, I am.
Do you have kids?
One 14-year-old.
Well, isn't this a perfect Mother's Day gift for tomorrow?
I know, she's screaming here behind me.
Anita has been a regular contributor to our show. Anita Karbindalal, is it right?
That's it.
Okay, great stuff. Well done, you've deserved it.
Anita, Thank you so much.
You want to say how's it to all your family and friends and listening into the show this morning?
Yes, hello to everybody that knows me out there, and especially to my mom, Mrs. Mado in Shawcross, and my mom-in-law, Mrs. Kabindalal in Redland. Everything of the best for tomorrow, and all mums out there as well.
Now, Vikash, this was a bit convoluted. Would you like to explain to the listeners exactly what happened there again?
Yes. The two glasses, firstly, as Ray mentioned, one, both have water. One, its temperature is 31 degrees Fahrenheit. The other one, the water in the other glass, has a temperature of 41 degrees Fahrenheit. You're dropping two coins into the glasses, one into each glass, and the question was, in which glass will the coin reach the bottom first? Now, the glass that has a temperature of water with measuring 31 degrees Fahrenheit is the equivalent of 0 degrees Celsius, which is your freezing point. And as you know, 100 degrees Celsius in scientific terms is your boiling point. So if the glass has a freezing point of 0 degrees Celsius, the entire glass, the water, would have been iced because it would have been frozen. And of course, the coin wouldn't reach the bottom as fast as it would have reached the bottom of the glass with a temperature of 41 degrees Fahrenheit.
So, you know, very, very convoluted, but it makes it all the more exciting to win a major prize, isn't it?
There we go. Absolutely. Anita Karbindalal, well done to you. 2,500 Rand DSTV decoder satellite system fully installed for you and the family. And actually, we should say congratulations to her husband because he wouldn't have to talk to his wife for the evenings.
That's right. And going through your GK questions and your cryptic clue for the last hour, firstly, a GK question. What was the number on the back of the soccer jersey that both Maradona and Pele said was lucky? And Vikash, the answer is?
I'm not sure, Nere. I have absolutely no idea.
You have no clue?
No, nothing. Nothing whatsoever.
The answer was 10.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. I thought about this long and hard, and I just couldn't get it.
Yeah, thanks so much for the clue. Correct answers from Dineshan Govinda of Eden Vale, Ravi Govinda of Durban, and Tabi Lakanapla Mercy.
You see, Tabi would not have cracked it had I not given him a clue.
And Tabi says that's why you should never ever write the answers to your questions on the same page that you faxed to Johannesburg.
No, you didn't write this answer.
I didn't. Your cryptic clue, submitted judge went wrong. The answer is referred. Correct answers from the nation governor of Eden Vale, Nandlal Mystery of Danhauser, Dharma of Peter Maritzburg, and a couple of other guys, I think, that I don't have the names here, but if you did call through the correct answers, well done to you. And it's now time for dedications. Because
yes, I've got a whole whack of dedications because I know, Ray, you want to get your breath back for a moment. Here's one that says, to all mums, have a wonderful Mother's Day tomorrow, an absolutely wonderful day in the kitchen. That comes from Porky, which is, he's always such a wonderful soul. he needs help. Congratulations to Anil Singh on attaining his LLB degree. Lots of love from Mummy, Priyan and Riddashni. Here's also another greeting that goes out to Swati Patel of Fordsburg. It says, happy birthday for today. All the best. May you be blessed with joy and be showered with love. And may you never forget how special you are. Lots of love from the Joburg Junglies. That's JJ, Radha Ben, Hasu Ben, Fatima and Ilona. Another greeting here says, please wish Cookie and Mukesh Amarlal, good buddies of mine, a very happy wedding anniversary for the 7th of May, belated wedding anniversary that would have been a couple of days ago. Hope they had a great day. May God bless you with many more years together. Lots of love from Rivashni Jagru and family. Incidentally, whilst we gave away the DSTV decoder for the Indian bouquet, Mukesh Amarlal happens to work for one of the Indian bouquet channels, and that's ZTV, my ex place of employment. To Roshan, happy belated birthday from wife Swati and children Nishan, Sanam and Sohini. They're all out in Fordsburg, Johannesburg. He is wishing three adorable mums, Zuleika Majid, Yashomati Bhagat and Parvati Parshotam, a very happy Mother's Day for tomorrow. All the best. Love you stacks from Famida Majid, who sent through that greeting. Happy birthday to Mum Swati. May you, we may not say it often enough, but we love you lots and want you to know that you are the eighth wonder of the world. That's a nice thing to say. Have a great day today and may tomorrow, Mother's Day, be even more special. Lots of love from Nishan, Sanam and Sohini, the little Tofani. To Dolly Mosi, Devika Mosi, Chopsi Mosi and Shanti Mosi, happy Mother's Day. Lots of love from kids. Lavisha, Kiri, Yuan. Vikash, Sanam and Nishal, Mala, Neta, enjoy it. We love you stacks. Happy birthday to Sharila Singh of Verlam. Message comes to you from parents Mohan and Shakila. Not forgetting sisters Nivasha and Avisha. Heartfelt birthday wish going out to dearest Reshmi Nandlal of Isipingo. Celebrates her 16th birthday today. Wishing you great success. Many more such wondrous occasions and the greatest of joy in life. All your dreams come true from Mom Rita, Dad Ramesh, Sister Rishana, Ma and Aji, your cousins Pranika, Sarika, Sandesh, Vikash, Sanjeev, Satish, Shivan, Shivana, Sarisha, not forgetting the rest of the family as well. Well, I think we covered everybody there anyway. That's all the guys from Durban. To sweet pals Yashomati Bhagat and Famida Majid, from them to Fatima Yunus, Farida Bayat, Dilshad, Array, Asha and Bolton, also Faye and Babu. Love you guys, Tux. Have a super-duper weekend. Here's a happy birthday greeting that goes out to Nirita Singh of Hillary. Birthday wishes come to you from husband Deepak and your son Vidan. Congratulations and best wishes to Prem Maharaj of Nalia Road in Pietermaritzburg on your 60th birthday. Lots of love from your young wife Meera, it says, your children, grandchildren and the rest of the gang. Lots of love from Sham.
Okay, you have a breather after this one and I'll take over.
Yeah, and I've got two left to go.
Okay.
This one just says, to Prem Maharaj, who celebrates his 60th birthday, it's hard to find a whiskey that is as matured as you are.
Ah, touche.
Yeah. Wishing adorable daughter Tejal Singh of Isipingo from parents Rakesh and Shaman, also cousins Vidan and Rivanta, and a happy birthday to Anil Singh of Vedlam. Best wishes to you from wife Aarti, children Asteel and Ashmita. And finally, from my side, a happy birthday to Reshmi Nandlal of Isipingo, celebrates her 16th birthday today. Lots of love from Thomas Kaka, Premi Kaki, Ritesh, Pranisha, and Trisha, all of Benoni in Gauteng.
Okay, tons of dedications from my side. Firstly, bon voyage to Mrs. N.K. Maharaj, who is off to New Zealand, with love from Meera, Danila, and Bubbly, and the rest of the Maharaj family. Then to someone, mutual friend here, Vikash, Suren Harichand.
Yes, fantastic singer.
That's right. Happy birthday for the 12th of May. Comes from your wife, Ashina, and all the boys and the rest of the family as well. And then to Sanjeev Shivasankar. This is Dada of Johannesburg. Happy birthday to you. Comes from Kathy, from Keyura, also from the Shivasankar family in Phoenix and all your family and friends in Durban as well. And then best wishes from Mrs. Fatima Vahid to the following people for birthdays for the month of May. Mr. T. Chetty for the 15th, to Rafiq Kaji for the 16th, to Ahmed Serkat for the 17th, Shakira Parker for the 23rd, Naeem Vahid for the 10th, Simran Mathura for the 25th, and to little Commission Chetty for the 28th. Birthday greetings to Ahalya Singh of Reservoir Hills, to Roseanne Maharaj and to Navita Mangal of Chatsworth, from Ashwin Raksha, Akshar Neha Mangal and Mummy of Woodhurst. Dedication to Roshil Prithraj of Ottawa, happy birthday from Videsh, Roshni, Pari, Kavi, Mum, Dad, Bhai, Gyan, Sani, Reshma, Rishikesh and Sandeer. Also wishing Videsh Maharaj a great and happy birthday from Roshni, Pariksha and Kavish. Happy birthday to Rajiv Pandey of Westville, Mrs. S. Maharaj of Ottawa and Amit Maharaj of Gauteng, from Ranita Singh.
Then to Asha Ramsahi for tomorrow, happy Mother's Day from Varsha, Vijayan and Sunisha. Then to little Akifa, who calls us on the show every single week, happy birthday to you, my darling. This comes from your mum, Rueda, Dad Ali, your brother, Atizam, as well as uncles Peru and Bala, and also Vikash and I as well.
Yeah, happy birthday, Akifa.
Then happy birthday to Avantika Naidu of Midran, from Mr. and Mrs. Sunaran, Deepak, Ranisha, Jasveer, Yuthika, and Unhiti. Wishing Wijam and Mohan Harry happy anniversary comes from Joshila Jainan and Lavashni. Then to Jamila Palika of Cape Town, happy wedding anniversary from your husband Latif.